good evening. Sounds like the mic levels are high. Can we adjust the mic levels? Thanks. Thank you, Michael. So today is September the 6th, 2018, and it is now 6 p.m., maybe even, 6 p.m. on the dot. And we have a special meeting to call an order. We will start with a moment of silence, and then we'll go into our Pledge of Allegiance. We'll have our roll call, and then we'll proceed with this special special City Council meeting, City of Newburgh, once again, September the 6th, 2018. So if everyone would rise. Silent moment of reflection. Thank you very much. Pledge my allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. So may I please have a roll call?
Councilman Grice.
Present.
Councilman Jacobson. Councilwoman Mejia. Councilwoman Monteverde?
Here.
Councilwoman Rayford?
Here.
Councilwoman Sophocles?
Here.
Mayor Harvey?
Here. Thank you. So we'll go on to communications. Are there any communications? I don't see any communications on our agenda. We'll move on to presentations. I don't believe there are any presentations on the agenda. And we'll move on to...
executive session?
No, we're on
We're on a special meeting.
Okay, thank
this
you.
This is a special meeting prior to...
The work session.
Yes.
Due to time-sensitive matters of resolutions.
Right. As far as presentation, I requested a few discussions, and I don't see that.
Your presentations will be on the regular meeting agenda, so if you do take a quick look at the work session agenda,
right,
it shows the presentations for the regular meeting on Monday, and then your presentation is actually scheduled for the work session, which will be at the conclusion of this special meeting.
Okay.
Yep. Okay. Thank you.
Great.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you for the clarification.
Okay. Now, we are going to go to a comment from the City Council regarding agenda items, before the comments of the City Council, we're going to go first to comments from the public regarding agenda items only. So if there are any public comments from the public regarding the agenda items for this special meeting that we're having prior to our work session, please step forward. Okay. There aren't any comments from the public, so we'll move on to comments from the City Council regarding agenda items only. If there are, we will start with Councilman Grice.
I have none.
Okay. Councilwoman Monteverde.
I'll pass. Thanks.
Okay. Councilwoman Rayford.
Yes, I have a couple regarding Resolution 236.
Okay.
The question I have for that one is that where it says, whereas the city intends, that's the third paragraph, to undertake the water plant improvement, that right there, the $748,400, it says with a city match. Somebody please explain that to me.
So there are two possibilities for the funding on this. The first possibility is from fund balance. The second possibility is unspent capital dollars. However, those dollars were allocated for older projects, and we can't just allocate it to this new project without some either going to a state legislature, which is going to take time, or coming to council with regards to the old project that either wasn't completed. I'm doing the research on it now. Either way, if we're able to get this grant, it's cheaper than us having to bond for all of it. So we asked the grant, we're working with Dave Jenkins from Millennium, and I asked him, if I just put in fund balance, which I know is available, is it going to be an issue if I switch it to unspent capital dollars later once we get all the legalities fixed? And he said that wouldn't be an issue. So that's the funding source. Those are the two possible funding sources. Hopefully not being, I'm hoping not to have to touch fund balance for it.
Okay. And then the other one, other questions I have. Let me get to that one. Resolution 238. Again, third paragraph, it says the city intends to undertake the water meter replacement project at a minimal project cost of $2.7 million with a city match of $1.1 million.
Same scenario.
So with the same monies, you're saying?
So they're both original sources are coming from fund balance. In the event that I can free up the $1.3 million, I believe the number is, or close to $1 million, in those capital dollars, then we'll use that. But because I couldn't definitively say that the state legislature is going to do the act to pass it or any of those things at the time this resolution was needed, I didn't want to use that in case we run into issues.
So when you say city with the city match, do we have the money?
Yes, in fund balance.
In fund balance.
Yes.
We will have
water fund balance.
Okay. So what is the other question I have is that water meter replacement, why are we trying to do a project such as that? Everybody hear the question? Why do we need a water meter replacement?
I can answer that. So about 10 years ago, the city of Newburgh went through a mass meter install. So they installed brand new meters with drive-by technology. So right now, I can send a car out and we could read the entire city in one day. That technology had battery life of 10 years. So we're losing batteries every day. So if you go downstairs in your house and your meter, there's a box that has a battery in it that sends signal to my driver as he drives by. A lot of those batteries are going dead. There's brand new technology out now that goes to satellite and then right back to the plant. They read every 3 minutes. So the important part of that, there's two important parts, is that I can get data back every 3 minutes. So if you have a leak on your house, I'll know every 3 minutes that you have a leak. Right. It also has the capability to have an app for every customer's phone. So you can keep track of your water data. So it's really, really cool technology.
Right. This is part of the technology, I believe, that came forward the council before, when somebody can do something and all the data will come to their phone.
Yeah, so, talking about it, and this has been a long time coming.
Right. So if the water meter replacement has taken place 10 years ago and it's outdated, of course, anything that's 10 years is going to be outdated. My question to you, in the planning and development of this this meter replacement back then, they didn't see the batteries dying now?
Yeah, I mean, the new ones that we're installing now, so I'm installing them. If I install a new one in your house right now,
right,
we
install
the new software.
Right.
That new one has a 20-year battery life, not a 10-year battery life.
But was that seen then when it came before the council?
That was 10 years ago.
Because like you said, if it comes up again 10, 20 years ago, we're going to revisit it. So
yeah, well, all technology, all equipment has a useful life.
Right.
So it's likely that we did know what the projected useful life of the equipment was 10 years ago. We now have an opportunity to secure some significant grant funding to update the technology, which has a longer useful life. But yes, it will have to be replaced again. Maybe not in 10 years, maybe a little bit longer. But yes, the technology will have to be replaced again. All equipment depreciates over time.
I totally understand that, but what I'm trying to really get at is that, do we have to spend these money? Even though we have them, do we have to spend them? Because what we're trying to do as a council, we really want to conserve the monies that we have, and especially when you're talking about taxes, any kind of funding we want
to. Well, it sounds like something we want to upgrade to. I mean, there's
new
technology, right?
Yeah, we want to do that, but we want to make sure.
So this is an investment. So the big thing with me is non-revenue water, water that we're not getting paid for. I mean, we fixed 3 leaks today. It was 48,000 gallons of water that we were not getting paid for. So that's the biggest thing. With this new technology, it has leak detection based in every single meter. So every meter that goes throughout the city, I'll have a leak detector in that house. So if a main break happens at 3 o'clock in the morning, it's going to send me an email right to my phone.
Right.
So you'll save money.
We'll save money.
Absolutely.
It'll pay for itself over time. And
it's an investment.
It's an investment. And also, Katie, you said that these funds outside of the grant, which are the matching funds, you're saying that that's coming from fund balance. Are you saying is that coming from the water fund balance, which has a surplus from my understanding, and this money, these monies wouldn't affect tax levy?
Not the tax levy.
Exactly. Okay.
Water fund balance.
Water fund balance, yeah. Which
the other thing, I'm sorry.
Go ahead. No,
excuse me. So the other thing I want to add is that with the failure of this equipment, there's also added costs for us to have to go out there and address it. So in addition to the upgrade, the app to capture modern era technology, we also have the ability to possibly save the consumers on water if there's a leak that we detect. And water being as scarce as it is, it's timely for us to continue to just up our own game. We've already reduced our production by half. We were over 6 million gallons a day. We're down under 3. They just captured a significant amount of water today. And we believe that there's still a lot of other leaks out there that are yet to be detected. And this also captures the leaks that will occur in real time so that as they occur, we'll have the ability to respond. We believe that the net result is going to be less water produced, less money spent on chemicals, and ultimately a greater capacity in our community for additional investment, and that we have the water capability, water production capacity to do so.
We're applying for a grant. To get this.
Yes.
So the grant is going to be specific for this only, so we probably couldn't put it into other resources, right?
This is specific for the meter project.
And if we don't get the grant, we haven't made a decision to spend any money at this time.
Correct.
Right?
Right. The resolution to apply indicates that if you are that you've agreed to undertake the project, and if you get the grant funding, you will in fact expend the funds that you need to expend.
I mean, if we don't get the grant, then we have to make another decision whether it's worth to bond it over the life of the equipment.
Just to give everybody a real life scenario, today I had a gentleman call me. He went to Israel for a month. He's a city resident. His toilet started leaking. He came home to a $4,000 water bill.
What?
He had this technology. It would send him an email right to his phone. He could send somebody to his house.
And
they
could,
you know,
the grant.
How much was the water bill you said?
$4,000.
Not only that, how many meters are there sewer?
Mostly 6,000.
How much of the batteries to replace the meters? You can't replace the
economics.
Here you go. So at the end of the day, we have no way of reading the meters.
Yeah, if I can't right now, so what I call a non-red list, every time I go out and read the meters, I get more and more on my non-red list. So we actually have to go out by manual and read those. That's very archaic. So right with the new technology, we'll be able to, you know, go right to the computer and get them right off the bat.
I just want to capture George's comment. I was on the microphone. I think it's important for the community to hear that. When these batteries fail in the units we currently have, they no longer record water consumption. And so that's money that we're foregoing. It's not like we can go in and replace the battery.
Right.
So I think that's also important.
Quick question. So the new technology and software, and you can download the app, I understand. Will you be able to pay your water bill with this app?
No, but I know Katie's working on that.
Yeah, so
what we've done, we've had some trouble trying to get credit cards in with different vendors, trying to lower the prices. Our biggest issue has been with the taxes because those are larger bills, and there's a 3% fee on it. But because I've been having trouble just trying to get it off the ground, what I'm going to do just to get it in the clerk's office, in DPW has been asking for it, and a couple of other locations, is just use the same company we're using now at the 3%. When people are paying their $10 birth certificates or whatever, the smaller amounts, they're not worried, they don't really complain as much to pay that extra fee because it's only $3 compared to going to an ATM and paying all those fees. So we'll work with the water department on that just to get the system in place and see how it's working. And then once we have everybody on a credit card platform, then we'll put an RFP out because we'll know exactly how much we're processing on credit cards and be able to leverage against other companies to see who will give us the best deal.
Okay.
So who would do this work?
With the credit cards?
No. Oh. I'm sorry.
So this is how a vendor come in and do a mass install. They set up appointments. They take care of everything.
Now, this will be bidded out?
Yes.
Okay. Open bid.
Right now, we're standardized on one meter company. We didn't like that, so we wanted to have the four big ones and let them fight it out so we get our best price.
Okay. Councilwoman Safa, please. Comments?
I understand it.
Okay. All right. So that concludes our comments from the City Council. Now we'll move on to City Manager Report.
Thank you, Mayor. We'll start first with Resolution Number 235. It's a resolution of the City Council of the City of Newburgh assuming lead agency status under the State Environmental Quality Review Act for the Water Plant SCADA Improvements Project, declaring the project to be a Type 2 action and finding no significant adverse impact on the environment, and authorizing the city manager to execute all SECRA documents.
May I have a motion for Resolution Number 235-2018?
So moved.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Roll call.
Councilman Grice?
Aye.
Councilman Jacobson?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Councilwoman Monteverde?
Yes.
Councilwoman Rayford?
Yes.
Councilwoman Sophocles?
Yes.
Mayor Harvey?
Yes.
Approved.
Resolution Number 236-2018, authorizing the city manager to apply for and accept if awarded a New York State Environmental Facilities Corporation Water Infrastructure Improvement Act grant for the Water Plant SCADA Improvements Project for the maximum total cost of $1,871,000.
Do I have a motion for Resolution Number 236-2018?
So moved.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Roll call.
Councilman Grice?
Aye.
Councilman Jacobson?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Councilwoman Monteverde?
Yes.
Councilwoman Rayford?
Yes.
Councilwoman Sophocles?
Yes.
Mayor Harvey?
Yes.
Approved.
Resolution Number 237-2018, a resolution of the City Council of the City of Newburgh assuming lead agency status under the State Environmental Quality Review Act for the water meter replacement project, declaring the project to be an unlisted action, adopting Part 1 and Part 2 of the Environmental Assessment Form, and issuing a negative declaration.
Do I have a motion for Resolution Number 237-2018?
So moved.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Roll call.
Councilman Grice?
Aye.
Councilman Jacobson?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Councilwoman Monteverde?
Yes.
Councilwoman Rayford?
Yes.
Councilwoman Sophocles?
Yes.
Mayor Harvey?
Yes.
Approved.
Resolution Number 238-2018, authorizing the city manager to apply for and accept, if awarded, a New York State Environmental Facilities Corporation Water Infrastructure Improvement Act grant for the water meter replacement project for the maximum total cost of $2,750,000.
Do I have a motion for Resolution Number 238-2018?
So moved.
Do I have
second.
A second? Roll call.
Councilman Grice?
Aye.
Councilman Jacobson?
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia?
Yes.
Councilwoman Monteverde?
Yes.
Councilwoman Rayford?
Yes.
Councilwoman Sophocles?
Yes.
Mayor Harvey?
Yes.
Approved.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Cervino. I need a motion to suspend old business, new business, and possibly final comments from the City Council regarding agenda items since it is a special meeting.
So moved.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Roll call. On the motion.
Councilman Grice.
Aye.
Councilman Jacobson.
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia.
Yes.
Councilwoman Monteverde.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rayford.
Yes.
Councilwoman Sophocles.
Yes.
Mayor Harvey.
Yes. Now, I also need a motion for adjournment.
So moved.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Roll call.
Councilman Grice.
Aye.
Councilman Jacobson.
Yes.
Councilwoman Mejia.
Yes.
Councilwoman Monteverde.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rayford.
Yes.
Councilwoman Sophocles.
Yes.
Mayor Harvey.
Yes. So, City Council special meeting for September 6, 2018 is now adjourned.